every Monday morning. Eastern Kalam Mitsuga. You get ready for office, work like your boss has no mercy on you. And then you come back home tired, speeding on that tormenting, treacherous traffic, and set off again on day 2:25. Not finding time for anything else apart from your official work. And so, the unofficial work is forced on day 6 and day 7. To some, meaningfully monotonous, and to some, meaninglessly monotonous, and others, monotonous. And when a question for time out arises, it is usually the holiday plan. Packing your bags and venturing out, either national, local, or international. Why I'm so bored is that name a place and someone has been there, someone has seen it. So when you come back from holiday and tell your friend, saying, hey, I've been to so and so place, it was beautiful, it was amazing, out of the world. And then your friend yawns while your description away and says, hey, it is not a new place after all. So what happens? The re-energized and reinstated you is shrunk back to ground zero. What to do? Where to go? Toastmasters, I have that perfect destination on earth where I bet no one has ever gone before. Not the richest, smartest, nor the most powerful. And it is a place on earth. 75 degrees west, 30 degrees north. It is a place that would accept you as domain and send you back safe and sound only if you are the reserving one. Any guesses? Toastmasters, it is the Bermuda Triangle. Yes, as we all know, who has gone there has never returned to our place. But my friends, the secret is to get there in your own car. Yes. Get it enchanted and fly it, the Harry Potter style, between the sky and the water. And when you approach the triangle, you can see outside the window, the sun is as orange as ever. Its rays entering your cabin and illuminating it so beautifully that you just cannot take your eyes off your charming cabin. And suddenly, the car starts to rock. And the dust of it in compass goes berserk. And the car starts to drive. And you see out the window, the water appears ivory white. And before you can realize all these things, the car dives in. But without a splash. And it's not just breathing fine, but a thin fragrance just hits your head. And you start relaxing till the RPM of your heartbeat normalizes to the last decimal point. And as the neighborhood starts to fade away, you can see a road that's 100 meters ahead. And when you still realize that you're in your car, you're the first gear maximum towards the road. You're soon on the road driving under water. And then you see a signboard which reads Bimini Road. 5 kilometers ahead, Atlantis. And you start driving on the road. And you feel a strong magnetizing energy flowing to your mind and body. And on the other side of the road, you see those man-made flying objects, those man-made buried objects, stacked together in some museum. This cutoff takes its positive energy. And suddenly the car starts to speed up. And there you see in front of you a cloud that starts glaring at you. And soon you're transported through the cloud. And on the other side is the city of Atlantis. Standing tall and bright, shouting out Marvel, giving you stunned and stimulated. Your eyes are glued to appeal and grace. And when you want to step out of your car and go around and explore, you see that your feet do not touch the ground. You can effortlessly move on the city. And then you're soaked and drenched in the charisma. And suddenly, the light around you starts changing. It becomes soothingly darker. And then you see over your head the moon fluorescently glowing, increasing its power and captivating you. And slowly and conveniently pushing you into a psychic trance. A trance that lasts for who knows how long. And slowly, they get knocked out of this insatiable solace. You realize that you're on your way back home flying in your car between the dark sky and the water and reach home in the middle of the night. Since then, when you get a small timeout with anything that happens in your day, you get reminded of the mansion of mirth Charles and Daniel. A crisp and clear voice reciting, rejecting that many things in this world are in true. Their existence is of no use that benefits Mother Earth. Man must find true happiness. Consider the real things not man-made. Understand the meaning. She is an enigma, a riddle that requires ingenuity and careful thinking for its solution. Of your proposal.